What's good, people? This your boy Z the Real here, and I'm back with a video. And then this is when I make my Super Bowl predictions. These are going to be the two teams I think that's going to be playing in Super Bowl 53, and that's New England versus New Orleans. And before y'all start commenting, and before y'all discuss why you think I'm on your predictions, Before you get on me and get on the video and comment, I want you to please let me explain to you my reason for this. And just for the simple fact that these two have more to gain, you know what I'm saying, and more to lose than the other quarterbacks. If we look at the NFL matchup, the current matchup on the AFC-NFC, you got the younger quarterbacks, two of the league's youngest quarterbacks, because Goff has been in this league 3 seasons. Mahomes, this is his second season. You got two of the league's youngest QBs going against the older guys. Okay, these two are veterans, and Brady and Breeze have been around a very long time. They represent a league that's no longer around anymore. Okay, these two both came in the early 2000s, and Drew Breeze has just turned 40 just this week, and Brady's already 41, going on 42 this year. I mean, this is it for them. I believe these two are going to basically play, and they're going to basically retire after this, especially Brady. I believe that Brady does win. Let's say he defeats the Chiefs, which he just might. Because I'm going to be honest, man. The Chiefs are going to come out there swinging. I know this is Andy Reid, but the problem with Andy Reid is like everybody else. Andy Reid still has not defeated Belichick or Brady at all in the playoffs. But don't get me wrong now. I like the Chiefs. I think Chiefs is definitely going to be a dynasty. Okay, their time is definitely coming, but just not now. Just so long as Tom Brady is in a Patriot uniform, he pretty much owns the AFC. Except for Peyton Manning and, let's say, John Harbaugh with Joe Flacco, that's been the only two teams that's actually beaten him in the last 10 years. We're not going to even talk about when Big Ben got his rings and Peyton Manning, when he was a Colt. We're going to talk about the last 10 years. The Patriots have dominated the AFC in the last 10 years. This is the defending AFC champions 2 years in a row. They defended that AFC championship. So this is like I say, man. I don't see too many teams beating New England as long as Tom Brady and even Bill Belichick. Bill Belichick is the greatest coach in NFL history. Okay? This is this man's 8th in an AFC championship. That's like I say, man. Yeah, I like Mahomes. Don't get me wrong. Okay, Vic has been groomed him to be who he is. You know, Michael Vick has done a good job as a quarterback coach. Andy Reid took his time for Mahomes to really learn and be mentored by Alex Smith, but you're going against Bill Belichick and Tom Brady in what appears to be a very, very tough game. Like, Mahomes, I'm going to be honest, man. Mahomes can't afford to get cocky at all. He can't get arrogant. If he gets arrogant and the Patriots catch him slipping, that's it. Because here we got Phillip Rivers, and this is the best. May I remind you, this is the best I ever seen the Chargers play in a very long time. The LA Chargers ain't had a team this good since 2007-2008 when Ladainian Tomlinson was over there. You had Vincent Jackson and young Antonio Gates. Okay, you had Quentin Jammer. They had a squad with Antonio Cromartie, and he still couldn't even beat New England. Phillip Rivers and the Chargers are now 0-8, and this is from when they was even in San Diego. Still, to this day, cannot beat the Patriots. If y'all saw that game on Sunday, and you seen that the Patriots went up by like 4 touchdowns, by the end of the game, it was already over. They put up 21. And the Chargers, to me, have just as good a team as the Chiefs. Actually, that team is just as good. And they still, that couldn't even beat the Patriots, Bill Belichick or Brady. And I understand a lot of people hate that man on the right. Y'all can't stand him, but you got to understand, this guy is the once-in-a-lifetime player. Once Brady retires, we ain't going to never get another one of him. That's it. And for Drew Brees, look how long it took Drew Brees to get back to this NFC Championship game. Brees has not been back in another NFC Championship game since 2009-2010. And in my previous videos, I basically show y'all that Hurricane Katrina ain't really had nothing to do with it. Yeah, the Saints was inspired, you know what I'm saying, to try to make something happen for the state of Louisiana. But they didn't just win because of Hurricane Katrina. No, man, Drew Brees back then had a stacked up team. You had Reggie Bush when he was still in his prime. You had Pierre Thomas. You had Colston and Henderson. Okay, even that look who you had on defense. Yeah, Will Smith, rest in peace. Darren Sharpe or Malcolm Jenkins. I'm yelling Malcolm Jenkins back then. Okay? See, Malcolm Jenkins didn't just go to the Super Bowl last year. He went back then. Back then, when the last time Breeze won a ring was when Malcolm Jenkins was on defense. But he was younger then. Malcolm Jenkins was in his, like, early to mid-20s. Okay? But the thing, man, Breeze, this is the second year in a row where Breeze has a young Saints team and made them competitive. Because the Saints, Sean Payton struggled, man. The last 8 years was rough for Sean Payton trying to rebuild this team. The Saints went through our total rebuild mode. If y'all remember, man, the Saints had records where they were only winning 7 to 8 games. And this is going into like after 2013, when 2014, 15, 16, when they had Jimmy Graham over there, and those guys wasn't really winning like playoff games. They wasn't like competing in playoffs. The last, like, I think before last year, like let's say like 2015 and before, Saints was taking beatings. Because remember the Carolina Panthers that smashed them, Atlanta Falcons, you know what I'm saying, was went to take a division. They had trouble against Jameis Winston in Tampa Bay. The Saints have went through a lot of growing pains, but for Drew Brees to finally get that team back going, and for them to finally get back to this championship game, he is not going to lose. And I understand the Rams have worked hard. They definitely have a team going. I like what Sean McVay has done, and especially with Jared Goff. But let's just be honest. And yeah, even though you got Ndamukong Suh and Aaron Donald, the Saints have proven that they don't lose at home at all. And I told y'all that in my other videos. Okay? Look at against the Eagles. The Saints basically controlled the whole second half of that game. Okay? Yeah, don't get me wrong. Alshon Jeffrey missed a crippled catch, but no, Saints was just in control. You know what I'm saying? Drew Brees, and that's one thing about Brees, he figures out. This is not the Dallas Cowboys and Rams are up against. You up against the New Orleans Saints in the Superdome. You think that crowd was something else now? Wait until this weekend. That crowd's going to be even louder now. And this, like I say too, man, especially for Brees. Brees, this is it for him. Okay, Drew Brees has been playing, like I said, since 2001. He's not going to get too many opportunities. This is the last you're going to ever see a Brees, and he knows this. So I think what Drew Brees wants to do, he wants to play in the Super Bowl and then retire. Because once Brees retires, because I think next his contract is up in the 20, I think next season, the end of next season, right? So when it comes to 2020, his contract is up, right? If Brees plays in the Super Bowl and retires, the New Orleans Saints will save money. Because he can easily opt out of his contract and give the Saints the rest of that money. Because Brees ain't losing money at all. He's made enough money. He made a lot of money. That man made millions. But again, Brees knows that you may not ever get another chance. This is it. This is his moment. And especially if you Sean Payton too, man, you just defeated the defending champions. You can't go out losing to the Rams at your house, okay? You just defeated the team. Nick Foles, the man who beat Tom Brady, you want to one-up the Eagles. This is your chance to prove that you're the better team by not only by defeating Philadelphia, but also sweeping the Rams, beating them twice, and then beating New England. If you Sean Payton, that's what you want on your resume. You want to tie up, but you want to be able to one-up Tom Coughlin. Because if the Saints is able to get to the Super Bowl and let's say they defeat Tom Brady, they'll be a bet. They'll basically top the New York Giants. Because New York, yeah, of course, nobody's going to take away from what the Giants did. The Giants went 9-7 and won this, but the Eagles was able to beat them last year. And to me, the Saints got just as good of a team as the Eagles had last year. So this is what I'm saying, man. Like, if you Brees, you cannot go out with a loss at your house, at your home field, okay? And I'm going to say this, too, in the case of the Rams and Chiefs fans that may be pissed off with me and are going to attack my comment section if need be. Okay, I understand y'all, you know what I'm saying, you guys have suffered with your teams. Your teams normally don't compete for no Super Bowls because let's just be honest. The last time the Rams was in the Super Bowls when you had Kurt Warner and Marshall Faulk with Isaac Bruce. Okay, that was back in 2001. That was the year Brady basically stepped through and won that Super Bowl. Okay, that was Brady's first ever Super Bowl appearance when he took over for Drew Bledsoe. Okay, I understand it's been a long, very long drought. Like the Rams only have maybe like one ring, the one they won in '99, and that's just been it. They went from Mark Bolger to Steven Jackson, Sam Bradford, who didn't do nothing. Even Nick Foles was a quarterback over there in the last days of St. Louis when they came to L.A. Y'all forget, I think he went over there when Chip Kelly traded him. But look where he is now. So, you know, I get that, man. He back in Los Angeles. Y'all got y'all team again, and you in the NFC Championship game. I understand that, but you gotta understand, this man, Drew Brees here, don't lose. He don't lose the big moments at all. And like I've explained last year, right? If it wasn't for Marcus Allgaier making that bonehead play and not wrapping up, they would have, I believe they would have took the Eagles to the limit. Eagles would have had a run for their money. I'm serious, man. Eagles would have had a hard time slowing down this this New Orleans Saints offense. And even defensively, man, these guys can get down. We've seen this. So that's what I'm saying, man. I don't see neither quarterback losing in these AFC and NFC championship games. So basically, I believe the league wants these two in. It's going to be these two, and these two are going to basically play, and both of them are going to retire. Because, let's just be honest, you Robert Kraft, how long? You can't keep Brady for too much longer, man. You got to basically retire him so you can make room for a much younger quarterback. You're going to have to start development a quarterback for the future. Now, you traded Jimmy G already. The 49ers are basically on their way to contend again once he stays healthy. They can get Jimmy G with a good old O-line. The 49ers will be back in contention, especially since there's rumors. According to Jerry Rice, Antonio Brown wants to play for them when he wants to sign up for them in the summer in the offseason. And if the 49ers get AB, watch out. But again, man, you traded Jimmy G, who was supposed to be your Tom Brady's successor. Okay? That's supposed to be his predecessor there, but you trade him away. So if I'm New England, I'm going to retire Tom Brady just at the end of the season. I'm going to basically exchange one of my Pro Bowlers, trade one of these teams, maybe the try to trade the Jaguars, maybe the Redskins, you know, one of these teams so I can move up in the draft and get me a quarterback. Because there's going to be a lot of interesting quarterbacks. Quite frankly, Kyle Fuller, the guy from Oklahoma. I think that's his name, if I'm not mistaken. There's going to be a lot of guys like him coming out. So if you're New England, you're going to want you a quarterback for the future. You got to start over again. Yeah, I thank Brady for everything he's done in the league since my childhood, because both him and Brees been playing since I was a kid. And matter of fact, Brees has been playing since the Chargers was in San Diego. He started his career as a San Diego Charger behind Doug Flutie. Okay, Doug Flutie was his original mentor. He taught him well. Okay? But again, man, it's this time is up. And I'll be honest, man, the guys who were playing since Brees and Brady first came into the league in the early 2000s, a lot of those players are no longer around. The Ray Lewis's, the Michael Strahan's, okay, the Brian Dawkinson's, Donovan McNabb's, those guys are all gone, retired by now. Randy Moss, all retired. Chris Carter, retired. And the players these two had, who made them champions over the last 15, 20 years, those guys are gone too. Yeah, I mean, Brady still got a little bit of his the team he went to the Super Bowl with last year, but Brees has taken a completely new team. This ain't the team he had in 09-10. This is a completely different team. But no, I just think it's these guys' time to see who's truly better. Can Brees actually show that he can beat Tom Brady in the Super Bowl? That's what people really want to see. And in the past, NFL has let a lot of quarterbacks, Vernon QBs such as John Elway and Peyton Manning, retire with rings. So I believe, because I'm going to be honest, man, the Rams and Chiefs going to be around the next 5 years. The Rams and Chiefs ain't really going nowhere. Yeah, Andy Reid finally has a team that could basically compete for championships, but I don't think this is time. Because the regular season Patriots is different than the playoff Patriots on that end. And then for Jared Goff, he's not that good on the road anyway. I'm going to be honest. Jared Goff has lost pivotal games on the road. Quite notably, the Chicago Bears just this season. Because just because they in the snow, it doesn't make any sense. That's no excuse. You got to find a way to win the game. Okay? Because what are you playing football if you're not going to be able to play in the snow? All right? So that's just what I'm saying, man. I think it's going to be between these two. And I'm going to show you something real quick while we're on the subject. I'm just going to show you some highlights of the last time these two played. Because every time these two teams play, they put up very high ratings. Okay? Remember back in 09 when the Saints went on that Super Bowl run, him and the Brees and Brady put up numbers. That was like game of the year. I think this game was from last year, but just look at some of these highlights. Just look at how these two teams play. Gronk is definitely going to play, man. I think for Gronk, this is the time for Gronk to prove that he's truly the best tight end in the world, and that's beat KC. If Gronk is able to have a good game against KC this weekend, Patriots should have no problems in beating Mahomes. Again, it's going to be tough on both ends, but both teams, both New England and New Orleans got teams that can slow down the Rams and the Chiefs. Now, again, I could be wrong. If I'm wrong and they don't go, then I'll take that loss. But I just believe it's going to be between these two teams.
Was on the coverage, and they picked up for the second straight third down play, 12 yards. Good job by Gronk, stacking him inside, pushing off. Last week, Eric Berry really tight on him. That's pretty good coverage by Vaccaro there. You've got to get your hands on him, and just good protection. Five-man rush, safety blitzing late. Got Vaccaro on him. There's a pass underneath back to White. And he's tripped up near another first. They spot him enough for the first down. Gain of 10.
James White, he's another important player on the New England Patriots squad that's been playing very well. Okay, for the last two Super Bowls, this guy has basically stepped up big time and has played a very huge role in their success.
And now with pressure, Brady to the end zone, and it is caught for a touchdown.
See, for the Chiefs defense, you can't get caught slipping. Both teams can easily score at will.
This is just a great throw and catch. You're going to see Anzalone, the rookie, who receiver a different way. They don't have Amendola right here to go up the field. You see him go up, and he's going to run right out here wide, and the safety can't get there. He can't get there. He's one-on-one, and Anzalone just has to know, hey, I got to protect the end zone here. There's no help over the top. Out of the ball as New England has run.
Second and 10.
Try to talk him into it, though, isn't Tom? Guys, it's at the line of scrimmage. And Tom Brady's fantastic at winning arguments, too. Look at this right here. You're going to see the pick play. And he hits him hard. And it opens Hogan up on the sideline.
Yeah, so I think this is what's going to come down to, man. And I truly believe Brady may win against Breeze. Either way, man.
Have a new attitude.
I mean, either way, yeah, it's going to be a very good game. Okay, but I believe that Brady might retire with 6 rings. He may win it all again for like the 6th time. Like I said, if that happens, then so be it. But I think it's going to be basically the NFL saying goodbye to these two. Definitely. And then let's look at the MVP standings, because I think Breeze is going to get MVP. Mahomes, nah, man, Mahomes is favorite. He's definitely favorite, but let's look at the ranks. Let's see. See again, it's between these two. Like I said, man, these two at the top. Sorry about that, but anyways, let's look at the rankings. I'm gonna do this before I leave. So let's look at the rankings. Look at the So like I said, man, like I said, it's going to be tough. Rams at 1. The Saints right here. See, I told you, they're not too far behind. They got Chiefs up there, but look at New England, 12-5. So, again, I think, like I said, man, they're not too far ahead, man. But, like I said, I personally don't feel that it's candidate KC's and, I don't think it's KC and LA's time yet. I really don't. I just think it's going to be between these two. So anyways, folks, that's the video. Okay, that's my prediction. May the best team win. You know what I'm saying? For Super Bowl 53, may the best team represent Super Bowl 53. But I just let you know, man, it's been a great season off the top. But I just feel it's going to be these two time to shine. These are going to be your quarterbacks representing us for the Super Bowl in February. Okay? I'll check back with y'all during Super Bowl week to give you my take as I compare both teams, offensive and defensively. Okay, so at the end of the day, man, I'll see y'all later, all right? Y'all stay blessed, stay tuned, I'll see you soon.